One question I would ask is there any conceivable set of observations that would be inconsistent with a God as an explanation? Can you give me an example? Like, what could we observe that wouldn't be consistent with God did it?
Evil.
But there is evil, right? Is there
Right,
not?
yeah, I know you're yeah, like you mean like logically?
Yeah, I'm just asking, like, what? So, if we're going to, if you said earlier that you appeal to abductive inference, you want the best explanation. Well, I mean, in a certain sense, God is the best explanation for anything. But something that's a good explanation of everything isn't a particular, isn't a good explanation of anything in particular. I mean, one could propose God did it for literally everything. I could walk in the room, the glass of water tipped over. Who did it? God did it.
I
You could
jokingly say
always
that
say
all
God did it.
the
So.
This is why I told Atangelo earlier, and Lance, you were having connection issues. I don't think that the God hypothesis, more specifically a disembodied mind, predicts anything, right? Because everything is consistent with it.
Right, so that's another way to put it. Is it? It's not that it doesn't predict anything; it's that it predicts everything.
Right. Yeah, that's
So
it.
something that predicts everything predicts nothing.
Well, I actually have two approaches to this. One is positive evidence, where we observe intelligence being capable of writing instructional assembly information, like making a blueprint or a floor plan, which then is transmitted and used to actually construct complex machines. We know as intelligent beings, we are capable of doing this. This is positive evidence. And analogously, we see that in operation in biochemistry and in biology in each cell, where the DNA molecule stores information which instructs how to make molecular machines, which are proteins. Now, we have also eliminative inductions,
You're
which
missing the
means
point.
that, well, I would like to finish how I see it, okay? So, and the other point is that when we don't see how natural, unguided, non-intelligent mechanisms can instantiate these things, so that is also evidence that intelligence had to be involved somehow.
Okay, Otangelo, I completely agree with you 100%. I think you're just totally right. But these guys are not convinced by this at all. It doesn't seem like it's making any impact on them. So my question is why? Like, what is it that's not, what is not hitting you guys about this, idea of, hey, we see, the point that Otangelo is making. What's wrong with it?
What I would say is that an explanation has to be narrow. And one of the concerns that I have with God as an explanation for phenomena is exactly what I'm alluding to, which is that the God did it is consistent with all possible observations. And so unless that can be convincingly denied, then one could always say God is a possible explanation. But what I would want to hear are good reasons to think God is a better explanation. And simply proposing that I lack a specific compelling explanation is just—it's literally, and I hate to drop the trope, but it's a God of the gaps. I mean, I could always—you're a detective. You show up at a crime scene. Someone got murdered. You don't know how they did it. Well, God did it. You show you—you know—you could always. Someone ate my pizza. Who did it? God did it. You could always propose God did it, and then what people will do when they argue from the theistic point of view is they'll put the onus entirely on anyone that doesn't think God did it to say, you explain it. And if you don't satisfy me, I get to say God did it. And you could always do that. And if you could always do it, I mean, what am I supposed to find convincing? Like, it's very similar to what Danny's saying, is that God doesn't make any particular predictions. It predicts literally all possible states of affairs. And so when you have an explanation that isn't narrowly constrained and tailored to the specific observations that you have, it's literally like the least parsimonious explanation that you could give. I mean, you might
Right.
as well say it's caused by omnicausality, and omnicausality causes whatever you observe. Therefore, omnicausality is the explanation.
Let me
That's
give you an
not
example.
informative.
I want to give you an example to what Lance is saying. Suppose you asked me, Danny, why are you talking to Lance right now? And I said, because of the Big Bang. Okay. Why is that not a good explanation? Because it doesn't seem, it seems like there could have been a big bang and I could have just spent time with my wife instead, right? The big bang doesn't predict whether I'm going to be in this conversation, nor does it predict whether I'm going to actually spend time with my wife. It's not a good explanation.